Let's be real, we have seen these videos. Magical Nvidia tweaks, best Nvidia control panel settings. But here's the truth. Dude, don't tell them the truth. Just make an ordinary YouTube video like everyone else. Hey everyone, welcome back to Shahbyte. My name is Shahryar, and in today's video, we're gonna talk about Nvidia Control Panel. It's 2025 and there is so much info out there about tweaking the Nvidia Control Panel and the newer Nvidia App. Some guides swear by specific settings, others say they don't matter anymore. So what's the real deal? Today, we are diving deep. We'll cover the essential settings in both the Nvidia App and the Classic Control Panel, explain what they actually do, look at the benchmarks, and bust some myths. Let's optimize your gaming experience. Let's kick things off with the absolute foundation. Keep your drivers updated. Grab the latest game-ready driver through the Nvidia App, GeForce Experience, or directly from Nvidia's website. This is non-negotiable for compatibility, bug fixes, and performance boosts in new games. Next, let's access our main tools. Search for Nvidia Control Panel. We'll start with some core system settings. Right here, adjust desktop size and position. It's all about how the GPU and display handles non-native resolutions. Under scaling, ideally use no scaling or perform scaling on display. Display scaling generally has less input lag than GPU scaling, but requires monitor support. No scaling is best for native res. Ensure override the scaling mode set by games is unchecked. Next, physics processor. Physics is used for physics calculation in supported games. Letting your CPU handle this can bottleneck performance, especially in titles that still use physics effects. Set physics to your dedicated GPU instead of auto or CPU. This offloads physics processing to your GPU, freeing up CPU resources and ensuring better consistency in physics-heavy moments. Inside the control panel's managed 3D settings, global settings, let's tackle the big ones. Shader cache stores pre-compiled game shaders to reduce stuttering and load time. The default is often too small. This is a highly recommended tweak. Set it to 10GB, 100GB, or even unlimited if you have plenty of C drive space. More cache means less stutter, especially in games you play often. Changing power management mode to optimal power lets your GPU clock speeds adjust based on load, saving power, and reducing heat. Prefer maximum performance forces max clocks consistently. Despite all advice, stick with normal globally in 2025. Modern GPUs ramp up instantly when needed. Forcing max performance 24/7 wastes power, adds heat, shortens GPU lifespan, and rarely gives noticeable gaming benefits. And also, we'll discuss per-game adjustments later. Before moving forward, let's establish a baseline. I ran an initial performance test after applying these core settings. Here's what we got. This will be our starting point. Later, we'll compare improvements after further optimizations. Okay, let's talk smoothness and eliminating that annoying input lag. These are vital, especially for competitive play. Low latency mode reduces input lag by limiting the number of frames the CPU prepares ahead for the GPU. On limits the queue. Ultra minimizes it further, but can sometimes introduce a stutter. Set this to on globally. It's a safe bet for lower latency without the potential instability of Ultra. In my case, I don't know why I don't have it, so I set this to off. But if your game supports Nvidia Reflex, enabling that in-game is the best option and will often override this setting anyway. You can experiment with Ultra under program settings for specific competitive games, but reverse if you notice issues. Prioritize enabling Reflex in-game. Vertical Sync syncs GPU output to monitor refresh rate to eliminate a screen tearing, but adds significant input lag. Force off globally. If tearing bothers you, use G-Sync. It's a much better solution. Background application max frame rate limits a game FPS when you alt tab out. Freeing up resources, set this to on and to a low value like 20 or 30 FPS in the control panel. Note that this often only works if the game is in borderless or windowed mode. Now, let's fine-tune visual fidelity and texture clarity. Some small tweaks here can make a very big difference. Anisotropic filtering dramatically improves texture clarity on surfaces viewed at an angle. Set this to 16x globally. The performance impact on modern GPUs is negligible, and it makes a big visual difference, even in games without an in-game option. If you encounter weird texture flickering in a specific game, try turning in-game anisotropic filtering setting off, or set this globally to application control. Now, let's talk about anti-aliasing settings. These settings related to a smoothing jagged edges. Set FX AA off globally. It is fast but blurry. Use better in-game anti-aliasing like TAA, DLAA, or MSAA. Set gamma correction on globally, else visual quality during anti-aliasing. For more, set application control. Let the game handle its anti-aliasing implementation. Set transparency off globally. Rarely needed can cost performance. Multi-frame sample AA or MFAA improves MSAA quality if you enable MSAA in-game with little to no extra performance cost over regular MSAA, and also doesn't do anything if MSAA isn't used. Set this on globally. It only activates when needed and provides a benefit then. If you never use MSAA, you could turn it off, but leaving it on is harmless. Texture filtering balances texture filtering quality versus speed. Quality is the default. Performance prioritizes FPS slightly more. I set this to performance to maximize FPS. Okay, we'll cover the ton of global settings, but one of the most powerful tools is program settings. This is crucial. In either the app or control panel, go to Program Setting tab, add your specific game's exe file. Now you can override global settings just for that game. I want to change low latency mode to ultra for this game only. Maybe set power management mode to prefer maximum performance just for this demanding title. Now, let's check performance after these game-specific tweaks. Now show them huge FPS boost and lie them about the truth. Surprisingly, the FPS remained nearly identical, still hovering around 65-66 FPS. But why no improvement? Now, about those conflicting guides. One analysis actually benchmarked default versus optimized versus performance settings and found virtually no difference in average FPS and sometimes even worse performance with the tweaked settings in modern games. The argument is that modern game engines often bypass these driver level settings, and Nvidia's defaults are generally well optimized. The continued prevalence of optimization guides recommending these tweaks is attributed to the topic being easy clickbait, with many guides simply repeating old, unverified recommendations. So while the settings we applied are generally considered low risk, be skeptical of guides promising huge FPS gains from tweaking every single control panel option. Defaults are always the safest bet. But don't worry, some gains come next. Now, search for Nvidia. You can find Nvidia Overlay here. Nvidia Overlay is in-game overlay for performance monitoring, recording, filters, and etc. If you don't actually use the overlay, turn it off. Tests consistently show these can significantly reduce FPS even when not actively displayed or used. And also, here in the app's global settings, you can find RTX Dynamic Vibrance. It's newer feature aiming to enhance color clarity per game. It can often make colors look unnatural, You can adjust digital vibrance in the control panel instead if you want more color power. In the control panel, adjust desktop color settings allows tweaking brightness, contrast, gamma, and vibrance at the driver level. Avoid adjusting brightness, contrast, and gamma here. You can use your monitor physical controls for that. However, increasing digital vibrance can make colors pop nicely in game without impacting performance. Experiment to find what looks good to you, but make sure to set this to default once you're done gaming to ensure accurate colors for other things. Before we start, let me clarify. For this test, I've reverted all the settings from chapter 2, 3, and 4 back to default. Only the chapter 1 and 5 optimizations remain active. Now, let's see how these modern app focus tweaks perform compared to our baseline. There we go. A good FPS boost purely from Chapter 5's optimizations. This proves that a lot of control panel tweaks showed no improvement. Here's the golden rule for Nvidia control panel from now on. Less is often more. You don't need to tweak every single setting. Many YouTube guides push endless chains, but our Chapter 4 test proved that blind optimizations do nothing. Always learn the why before copying any guide. Before I let you go, real talk. The comments on my last video, you are the reason why I bother digging through this stuff instead of just making another Ultimate FPS Hacks clickbait feast. Keep being legends. Farewell.